Hi,
hi,
good morning, Carly.
How are you doing?
Good.
Welcome to the Coral Reef Futures Molecular Lab at the Rosenstiel School of Marine Atmospheric and Earth Science.
This place is so cool. What is this right here?
So corals themselves are animals, and they live in synchrony. They live with these tiny little algae that basically provide them with the food and nutrition that they need.
Wow, so what is this space?
So this is the Rescue a Reef Lab. This is where we take coral colonies and we can fragment these corals and divide them into identical replicates that then we can go out and put on reefs and provide that three-dimensional structure that is really important for shoreline protection.
How is climate change affecting corals?
So corals are incredibly sensitive organisms. They are stressed by a lot of different things. And when these changes happen one on top of another, it can actually cause the corals to become incredibly stressed, which reduces their health. And if the temperatures don't go back to what we consider normal, the coral can't recover. It can't provide itself nutrition, and it basically will die.
So you're helping here make corals more resilient to that change.
Exactly. So what we try to do is put them in environments where they're gonna thrive. So now we can head to our spawning lab. It's one of my favorite spaces in the entire lab. These are adult coral colonies, and every year they will reproduce and they will spawn in synchrony.
Is that one of the reasons why it's important to protect these vital ecosystems?
So overall, to help save these coral reefs and coral reefs globally, we have to work together. I encourage everyone to go out, go snorkeling, go scuba diving if you can, and go see these ecosystems